hope you're all very well, and this video is to help everyone make sure that when we come back to school, we do so in a safe way, a knowledgeable way, an informed way, and a timely way. So watch the video all the way through to the end. I'm sure it will answer some of the questions you might have about coming back to school, which is going to start very soon indeed. So watch carefully, listen carefully, and let's see what we will learn. Now, some of our children will be starting on Wednesday of next week, but some children haven't stopped coming to school at all during the time that we've been closed to others. And so on Monday of next week, we're going to start putting into our plans about the safe opening of the school. So some of this is to do with the key worker children. Some of this video will be to do with the nursery and reception children. Some will be to do with the year one children, and some will be to do with our year six. Now, different groups of children will have to do different things at different places at different times. But all of those differences add up to one common thing: all of us being safe in our school. And what we're going to do now is take you through a typical day at school, and you get an idea of how school has changed, how many things are still exactly the same, and what you will have to do to play your part. And that means children and parents too. And to be at school, you've got to come to school. So let's start outside and find out what we all have to do. Okay, and our journey at school belongs here, along Taylor Road. There's lots of places to park along Taylor Road, so please don't squeeze up together. Keep a distance. And if you look over here, it says keep school clear in yellow paint. But that's not the only yellow paint you're going to see here at Oldfield Brow. Let me show you some more. Okay, now there's lots of different ways into the school now, and this is just one of them. If you want to find out which entrance you need to use, have a look at your leaflet and it'll tell you exactly where to go. But one thing that you'll find is that all over the place there are yellow dots, and each of them is 2 meters apart. So please keep that social distance as you walk into school. And that's exactly what we're going to do right now. Okay, so if we look around, there are more yellow dots, and that's what we've got to do. We've got to keep that distance. If there's somebody in front of you, just wait for a moment, and then let's get into school safely. Now, these yellow dots are everywhere. They're to look after us, to look after you, to look after your parents. And so whatever you do, don't diss the dots. And from the moment you walk into school until the moment that you walk out of school, you're going to be part of a bubble. A bubble that's made up of your friends, and a bubble that's made up of special people, our school staff, that you all know. Now, all of the bubbles are in these instructions here. And as soon as you go into school, we want to make sure that any germs that you might have brought with you, we've got rid of. So as soon as we go in, we clean our hands, and here at the door, you'll be met by one of the adults that will be looking after you. Then, when you've cleaned your hands, you've said goodbye to Mum and Dad, or just Mum, or just Dad, because only one adult, then they need to go straight off, and you need to go straight off to your classroom. And there, your day will begin. Now we're outside, and that's where you're going to be as often as it can be done. Now, every child in every group will have their own particular area in which they can be. So one bubble will fit into one area of the playground. So lunch times, as much as we can, will be outside, and even lesson times too. Fresh air is good for us. There's nothing new about that, but at this moment it's even more important. Now, in your bubbles, there'll be no more than 15 children. And at the moment, our average in each bubble is 12. Some is a little bit below that, some is a little bit above that. But it will never, ever be more than 15. And that bubble will stay together for that whole day and that whole week. And we hope by doing so, everybody will have their own place.
playtime, their own lunch time, their own play area. And everybody will get to know everybody so well within their bubble.
Okay, well, we've been outside, so what we need to do is clean our hands. And now let's go into our Year 6 classroom. Now, as you can see in here, some things are different, but some things are very much the same. But we know our Year 6, and they're very grown up, and they're very responsible. And if we ask them to do something, we know they can. So if you look around the room, you'll see there's little purple stickers everywhere, and that's where the children will be sat, appropriate distance away. And if you were to count up the stickers, you'd only find 15, because we won't have any more than 15 children in a room at any one time. Hi, Mrs. Norbury, how are you?
I'm very well, thank you, Mr. Merrill.
Good, well, lovely to see you. Now tell me, what are you looking forward to with the children coming back?
I'm looking forward to seeing even more children back in school sensibly and safely. I've missed seeing them and can't wait to welcome them back.
Excellent. Now, what things do you think might be the same and what might be different?
I think the things that will be the same will be there are lots of fun things to learn, lots of people to be with, but it will look a bit different. The classrooms will be different. You might have a different teacher, but whoever you are with, we will do our best to look after you, to answer all your questions, and to make sure you feel happy and settled in school.
And what might be different?
Well, one thing that will be very different for most of our children is that they'll be going home at Friday lunchtime, to make sure that the grown-ups in school can give everywhere a really, really good clean, so that by the time you come back on Monday, it will be all sparkling and safe and ready to go.
Thank you very much indeed. Well, you might know where we are at the moment. We're at the Year 1 end of the school, and there's going to be no changes there when we come back. We have got some changes in our fish tank. Look at all these amazing creatures, a rainbow of life. And let's go into one of our new Year 1 classrooms. As you can see, all the children in this room are going to have their own special place and their own special resources. Just for them, and everything to be kept in these plastic bags that you see in front of you. There's lots of things to do here at school, and one of the things that we need to keep everybody doing is keeping their hands clean. And so in every room we've got hand sanitizers and we've got tissues and we've got a bin. Because we're going to catch it, we're going to bin it, and together we're going to kill it. And during the day, you'll see the teachers cleaning, because we've got these little buckets everywhere, so everything can be wiped down during the day. The children are going to work here, the children are going to learn here, and the children are going to have their meals here as well, looked after by the teachers, the classroom assistants, and the midday assistants. There are going to be some toys out for the children to use, but not a lot. But all the things that are used are going to be cleaned down each day so that they're all fresh and clean for our bubble to be kept the way we want it to be the next morning. Now, the teachers and the adults that might be in this room might not be the ones your child usually has, but all the work that the children will be doing will be planned for by the teachers. So, this is one of our Year 1 classrooms, and we hope that it's going to be... Oh, there's one thing missing though. One thing missing. The most important thing of all. Children. And so we're looking forward to seeing you back here very, very soon. Now, our children here at Oldfield Brow are rather wonderful, but also, so is our building. Because we've got this brand new building, we can move around it quite easily, and we all know that the left is the best. But just to remind us, as we travel around our school, when we have to go, then we've got these arrows on the floor to remind us that the left is the best. But if you go in the opposite direction, then you have to make sure that you can go the other way too. There won't be much moving around in school because everybody's going to be in their bubble. But we do need to go to the toilet, and so when we do, we know which side of the road, which side of the corridor to work on. And there'll be lots of doors that will be left open just to make sure that we get that fresh air moving around the school to wherever we
are
going.
This is one of the entrances to the school. We've got quite a few entrances now, and all those are shown on the information leaflets that's been shared with your parents.
But when you come into school, the first thing you're going to do is going to be to clean your hands. We've got the sanitizer here ready, and we've got the posters here. And if you can't read those, you can read these instead, because our key worker children are all been looking forward to seeing you, and they've been making some posters as well. So make sure you keep clean, make sure you stay well, make sure you keep a distance every time you come into school.
Hi, Miss Drabble, how are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Good. Are you looking forward to coming back to school and the children?
Can't wait to see all the children again. I miss them all so much.
Okay, and what are you looking forward to doing?
I'm looking forward to doing some arts and crafts, some fun activities, some maths and English, but trying to make it all fun and working together.
Okay. And when we do come back to school, what do you think is going to be the same and what do you think might be different?
I think things that are going to be the same are we're going to have fun together, we're going to have lots of activities together, we're going to see our friends again. A few differences will be that we won't be as close to each other in the classroom, we'll be washing our hands a lot more, we will be... what else? Having dinner times at separate times and playing out on the playground at different times. So there are a few differences.
Okay. And you're looking forward to it?
I can't wait.
Excellent. Right. Well, we'll see you very, very soon.
See you soon.
All right, people. You can either continue with what you're doing or...
Okay, just a few things to recap on before we finish. Firstly, be on time. Each group has got their own starting time and that's really important. Lessons will start soon after your starting time, and we don't want children to be late for lessons because they'll be late for learning and playing catching up, and we've had enough of that already. When you do come to school, make sure you keep a safe distance outside of school and inside as well. Very important. When you bring your child to school, just one grown up with them, both at drop-off time and at pick-up time as well. And when you have dropped off your child, please, straight home for parents as well. We don't want people by the gates because we need to keep that social distancing at all times. Children and parents, what do you bring to school? You bring your coat. Please make sure it's got your name on it. Please make sure that you bring your own named water bottle. It's really important. Can you also, if you have a packed lunch, make sure that that's clearly labelled? And those are the only things that you need. We don't want any toys bringing into school. We don't need any PE kit bringing into school. We don't even need any reading books or reading bags. So please, keep things at home. And at the end of the day, I know it's lovely to share with you the things that the children have been doing in school. But for the moment, we'll be sending nothing home at all. And at the beginning of each day, please help us by having good hygiene in school, by making sure that the children are in fresh uniform. Now, we recognise that trying to get uniform might well be difficult at the moment, especially things like shoes. But if you can, make sure the children look smart, they're being smart, and they're all clean and ready to go at the beginning of each day. If all of us play our part, even if it's a small part, all of those small things add up to something much, much bigger. And that's how we're going to work in partnership. And that's how we're going to make sure everyone is safe at school and happy at school. And we'll be seeing you soon at school.